We all wonder which diseases may lay dormant in our bodies. Is he destined to get cancer? Is she going to get Alzheimer's? Or is he eventually going to get Parkinson's disease? Almost everyone carries genetic changes within them which could trigger such diseases. Until now, only time-consuming laboratory analyses could give us information about which diseases might be inside us. With his tireless research, this man has declared war, Christopher Tumazu. This professor of electrical engineering at Imperial College in London is about to revolutionize medical diagnostics. With a quick test, he is making the signals in the genetic material of the body digitally readable.
My motivation and inspiration to do research in the field of human DNA is nature. Speech, sound, hearing, they're all natural signals. And in electronics, analog instead of digital is very natural.
The centerpiece of his invention is a microchip that rapidly analyzes genetic changes. Christopher Tumazu needs only a small DNA sample from someone. The transistor transmits the data to a microchip. With a USB stick, they are then loaded onto the computer. The results come after just 20 minutes. No more long waits. The patient can even run the test themselves.
So the key advantage of this technology is the fact that it uses a microchip. And as we all know, we find microchips in computers, and computers are very fast, so my microchip is very fast. Existing technologies use what we call optics. They use light. And optics don't scale in this miniature fast way in the same way as an electronic microchip does.
Tumazu's idea for the microchip is based on the principle of a puzzle. Because our DNA is a kind of puzzle. Some parts fit together, others do not. Here's how it works. The human genome is constantly making copies of itself. When it does, the DNA divides itself, like a zipper. Each half is used as the basis for a copy. Certain enzymes, called polymerase, read the string and add the appropriate ends, like a puzzle. Upon successful assembly, hydrogen ions are released. If there is an abnormality or deviation, the composition of the human genome changes. These modified strands compare the test with the DNA of the subject.
We all differ by 0.1%, and it's that 0.1% difference, or that error, if you like, in our jigsaw puzzle that my microchip technology is trying to detect. Because those differences tell us whether or not we can metabolize drugs differently, whether we've got different genetic diseases. So this chip, this microchip, will detect those errors in real time.
The chip detects the hydrogen ions that are released during the assembly of DNA. The more of it there is, the clearer the indication of a genetic predisposition. The reason for Christopher Tumazu's research in this field is very personal. Years ago, his son Marcus fell ill with a hereditary disease that leads to kidney failure.
I felt a desperate need to apply this technology to early detection. If we could detect something early enough, it becomes preventative medicine, and people like my son Marcus could have gone about their lifestyle in a very, very different way.
In 2015, this quick test will be used in clinics to help detect infectious diseases and other ailments. Tumazu's test is already in use in the cosmetics industry today. Using a chip, the texture and moisture level of the skin are analyzed. The data then helps the customer get the perfect product, tailored to their skin type.
We licensed it initially to the consumer beauty industry because there you can take the stigma away from it being medical, and it drives the consumer much more to an acceptance, and eventually the healthcare system will adopt this technology.
The rapid test is not the only revolutionary invention attributed to this dedicated visionary. Tumazu has also developed a patch with a built-in microchip. This saves data on all the patient's body functions and sends it via SMS to the doctor. In some American clinics, the patch is already in use. A system that monitors the blood sugar levels in diabetic patients and automatically administers the correct amount of insulin has also been approved.
I think in 20 years' time, medicine will be very, very different. And it's this technology that will then drastically reduce the time to get a result. And doctors will then be looking at your medical future instead of your medical history with technology like this.
His efforts to develop future methods for medical diagnosis have earned Christopher Tumazu a nomination for the European Inventor Award.
We're very excited that we've been nominated for the European Inventors Award. This is an award which I hope then will demonstrate, not just to Europe, but to the world, that a technology like this can be used to help mankind.
If that is enough to earn him the Oscar of Technology in the category of research, we will find out at the award ceremony in Berlin.